My scouts are posted on the ridges in case there's any trouble. Let's see what we have. Let us begin.
Has been known to bite.
You're kind of a force of nature, aren't you?
When I need to be.
It's impressive.
You flatter me.
I'm trying.
Did I do the right thing? What I have set in motion here could destroy everything I have revered my whole life. One day they may write about me as a traitor, a madwoman, a fool, and they may be right.
What does your faith tell you?
I believe you are innocent. I believe more is going on here than we can see. And I believe no one else cares to do anything about it. They will stand in the fire and complain that it is hot. But is this the Maker's will? I can only guess.
You don't think I'm the Herald of Andraste?
I think you were sent to help us. I hope you were. But the Maker's help takes many forms. Sometimes it's difficult to discern who it truly benefits, or how.
What's going to happen now?
Now, we deal with the Chantry's panic over you before they do even more harm. Then we close the breach. We are the only ones who can. After that, we find out who is responsible for this chaos, and we end them. And if there are consequences to be paid for what I have done, I pay them. I only pray the price is not too high.
You didn't have any choice.
Didn't I? My trainers always said, Cassandra, you are too brash. You must think before you act. I see what must be done, and I do it. I see no point in running around in circles like a dog chasing its tail. But I misjudged you in the beginning, did I not? I thought the answer was before me, clear as day. I cannot afford to be so careless again.
It wasn't like you had no reason to suspect me.
I was determined to have someone answer for what happened. Anyone. You've said you believe you're chosen. Does that mean you believe in the Maker?
I believe he exists.
That's comforting. Surely the Maker put us both on this path for a reason. Now it simply remains to see where it leads us. It occurs to me I don't actually know much about you.
What do you want to know?
I'm not sure. Where are you from?
I thought you knew that.
I suppose I could ask Liliana. She has collected a frightening amount of information on you. But I don't want to ask her. I want to hear it from you.
I was born in Oswald, and that's where most of my family is.
The Trevelyans, is it not? A large clan with a rather clever coat of arms. Tell me, do you consider the Free March as your home? Are you eager to go back?
Wherever I am is home enough for me.
That's how I feel now. After years of tending to business for the Divine.
I'd like to get to know you better.
You would?
Is that a problem?
Not entirely. I'm just curious as to your motivation.
Is there any harm in us becoming a little closer?
Plenty. Is that right? As you wish. My name is Cassandra Pendergast, daughter of the Royal House of Navarra, 78th in line for the Navarran throne. I joined the Seekers of Truth as a young woman and was with the Order until they withdrew from the Chantry. I remained as the Divine's right hand, carrying out her order to form the Inquisition. And here we are. That's all there is to know, my lady.
You're a member of Navarra's royal family.
The Pendergasts are a very large clan. Half of Cumberland could say the same.
Really?
No, but it feels that way. I have hundreds of relatives so distant they need charts to prove we're related at all. And they have them. Oh yes. The Pendergasts value their precious blood like it runs with gold.
The Seekers to get away from them.
It was a life worth getting away from. The Pendergasts are famed for dragon hunting, but few actually pursue the craft. Most are fat and lazy. They pay lip service to the Maker and care only for idle pleasures and past glories. My brother was all that kept me in Navarra. Once he was gone, so was I.
Tell me about your brother.
I would prefer not to speak of Anthony. Another time, perhaps.
So you are the right hand to the Divine?
To Divine Justinia, yes. And Divine Beatrix before her, in fact. The position is normally reserved for Templars of the Knights Divine, but my circumstances were unusual.
Unusual how?
You don't know the story? Thank the Maker. I will tell you if you wish. But it isn't as exciting as some drum it up to. The old version is that I once saved the previous Divine's life. My reward was becoming her right hand.
But what does a right hand do, exactly?
What is your hand capable of? It gives, it takes, it beckons. It makes a fist. Liliana and I extended the Divine's reach beyond the Grand Cathedral. We went where she could not. After Beatrix, I was tired of the position and wanted to return to the Seekers. But Justinia convinced me to stay. Her vision for the future gave me hope.
You thought she could really change things?
Justinia knew the war was coming long before it began. She tried to avert it, but the forces arrayed against her were too strong. Sometimes you have to break a bone so it can be reset. That's where the Inquisition comes in. It was to be the answer. A means to preserve as well as an agent for change. I only wish she had lived to see it.
So, what's the story about you becoming the right hand?
Sweet Andraste, do you really want to hear that? It was, what, 18, 20 years ago? Some still discuss it like it happened yesterday. The tale gets bigger each time it's told. I barely recognize myself within it now.
That's what happens with stories that become legends.
I am not a legend, nor was I then. I was a young woman, barely out of training. To hear others tell it, I alone saved Divine Beatrix from a horde of dragons sent to assault the Grand Cathedral. Rather impressive for such a young seeker, wouldn't you say?
And the truth is?
I stumbled upon a conspiracy to kill Beatrix. A Templar Knight Commander was at its heart, and there was a dragon battle at the Grand Cathedral, but I had help from loyal mages who rallied to the cause. They freed the dragons from magical control. Without them, the Divine and I would both have died. Yet I became the right hand, and they are forgotten.
What happened to the mages that helped you?
They went back to their circles, with rewards and privileges and most holy gratitude. Many of them died at the conflict.
You're delightful. You know that?
No, I do not know that. I object. There is nothing delightful about me.
I beg to differ.
I think I preferred you in the stocks. You don't seem to like your homeland much.
My family polluted it for me. What little I saw of my homeland was through the bars of a gilded cage. My uncle treated me like a porcelain doll to be placed on a shelf and dusted only when necessary. Thus, I did not see Nevarra, the real Nevarra, until much later. By then, I realized I knew it not at all.
Your uncle? What about your parents?
They had the misfortune of taking the wrong side in the second attempt to overthrow King Marcus. The king executed them, but spared my brother and I since we were family and children at the time. Thus, we were raised by my uncle, a mortal Etarsi who preferred the company of his corpses to the living.
Your uncle was a mortal Etarsi?
A death mage. He still is. My countrymen do not burn the dead. They bury them in special crypts. The mortal Etarsi supervise the crypts, like priests. Uncle Vestalus oversees the grand necropolis. Nevarrans spend more time honoring dead relatives than they do with living ones. It is odd to be so fascinated with death and its trappings. I will never understand it.
I'll let you get back to work.
You dislike the Templar system?
No. I know their purpose, but you remember, I once ministered in a circle chantry.
Yes. I assumed you were used to having Templars around, keeping us safe from the mages.
The mages in the circle follow the Chant of Light as faithfully as the Templars, sister. More faithfully than some Templars, even. Some of the things those Templars did when they thought I did not see.
I will keep the peace while you and the others appeal to the Chantry in Valroyo.
Better ready yourself for the blame you will be rightly assigned.
I will keep the peace while you and the others appeal to the Chantry in Valroyo.
Better ready yourself for the blame you will be rightly assigned.
Blessed are the peacekeepers, the champions of the just. Blessed are the righteous, the lights in the shadow. In their blood, the Maker's will is written. Is that what you want from us? Blood? To die so that your will is done? Is death your only blessing?
You speak for Andraste, no? What does the Maker's prophet have to say about all of this? What's his game?
How is this a game?
Do you see the sky? What about the temple ruins? The bones lying in the dust? Even if you didn't support the Divine's peace, you wouldn't call this right. Who could? So many innocent lives. The faithful murdered where the holiest of holies once stood. If the Maker willed this, what is it if not a game or a cruel joke?
Don't ask me. I'm as baffled as you are.
Then we can only guess at what he wants. The Chantry teaches that the Maker abandoned us. He demands repentance for our sins. He demands it all. Our lives, our deaths. Justinia gave him everything she had, and he let her die.
I'm sorry. Her death has clearly hit you hard.
Not just me. All of us. She was the divine. She led the faithful. She was the heart. If the Maker doesn't intervene to save the best of his servants, what good is he? I used to believe I was chosen, just as some say you are. I thought I was fulfilling his purpose for me, working with the divine, helping people. But now she's dead. It was all for nothing. Serving the Maker meant nothing.
Maybe you have another purpose. I could help you find it.
No, this is my burden. I regret that I even let you see me like this. It was a moment of weakness. It won't happen again. Come, to work then. We will speak later. So it's true. Butler has stand on us. I hope my hunch was wrong.
You knew him well?
Not as well as I thought. Show me the report. There were so many questions surrounding Faria's death. Did he think we wouldn't notice? He's killed Faria, one of my best agents, and knows where the others are. You know what must be done. Make it clean. Painless if you can. We were friends once.
It will be done.
I'm sorry you had to see that. Trust me. Everything I do is to protect our interests. Now, if you're happy, I have more work to do. Reports of fade rifts and demons keep coming. The people are terrified, and it's only getting worse. The only thing that will calm their fears now is the hope that someone out there can save them. You have to be that someone. No one else has any power over the rifts. Seal them. Your legend will spread, and Thedas will learn to trust the Inquisition.
Why do you want me to seek out the rebel mages? Why do you care?
I've known mages. Some of them were better people than me. And yet I'm free and they're not. It's not right.
They called you the left hand of the Divine.
That they did? What of it?
What is the point of an Inquisition?
Justinia would have started the Inquisition if the Divine Conclave failed to restore peace. She hoped that, with enough support, we could challenge the very tenets of the Chantry. She wanted the Chantry to treat the mages fairly. But sometimes I wonder, why stop at mages? The Chantry has committed many injustices. If we're going to change it, why not change the whole thing? It's just a thought. None of this will be possible if we fail.
I'll try not to break anything.
That's good to hear.
I could use the left hand of the Divine at my side out there.
Every agent out in the world is my eyes, my ears, my blade. Wherever my people are, I am also. Coming with you, leaving my post, would blind and bound me. Do you see?
What exactly does the left hand of the Divine do?
A Divine always has enemies, and Justinia had more than most. I protected her. I watched, had an ear to every door. I identified threats, and I dealt with them.
Why did Justinia have so many enemies?
There were many who felt she was unfit to be divine. She had a past, a worldly life. And like many, she wasn't given to the Chantry as a child. She chose it, and somehow that made her unworthy. And because they thought she was unworthy, they wished her harm.
So you were her spymaster too?
I handled difficult situations that couldn't be resolved through more delicate means.
I'd like to hear about Justinia. What was she like?
A friend. A mentor. Like me, she had secrets, made mistakes. It made her human. I think her followers responded to that.
Was there something more than friendship between you?
You're asking if we were lovers? Typical. I was devoted to her, therefore it must be romantic. Love is common. Love is simple. My bond with Justinia was something greater. She was a sister, a mother, a teacher. So to answer your question, yes, it was more than friendship.
How did you and Justinia meet?
I met her a long time ago, before she became divine. Before she was Justinia. When I met her, she was Mother Dorothea. I was at my lowest. Broken. Lost. And she saved me. No, wait. She hates it when I say that. I saved myself. She just showed me it was possible.
We'll talk more later.
Did you need something?
Let's talk about you.
Me?
Bards tell tales. I bet you tell some good ones.
There are plenty of tales in the library. Perhaps you should look for them there.
What did you do before you worked for the Divine?
I was a bard, an Orlesian spy, for many years. For a time, I also served a small cloister in Lothering. After the Blight, the Divine called on me to oversee her personal network.
Can you teach me to be a bard?
Being a bard is so much more than being a spy. It involves a keen understanding of politics. The ebb and flow of influence, the great game. The bards is an intricate dance where a smile can be sharper than any dagger. The best way to learn is to immerse yourself in it. Perhaps when this is all over, I'll teach you.
I should leave you to your work.
We can always talk later. Yes?
You seem to know a great many people.
I have made friends, and on occasion enemies. It's unavoidable.
You have a history with the Warden who ended the Blight, don't you?
I count her friends. She's probably the only person I trust completely. I haven't heard from her in some time. She just disappeared. I try not to think about what might have happened.
They say you spent some time in Lothering. Did you know the champion?
We spoke a few times. I seldom left the Chantry, and we never became more than casual acquaintances. I saw more of the Hawk twins. Bethany in particular. She would spend time in meditation at the Chantry, and she seemed to like my stories. The other one, the young man, he was a little surly. I did encounter the champion again later in Kirkwall. Those were terrible times.
Was this when the Chantry was destroyed?
No, that happened later. But even then, the news coming out of Kirkwall was disheartening. There were some in Val Rayo who wanted the Divine to declare an exalted march on Kirkwall. Justina sent me there to see if that could be avoided, to gather evidence to calm those agitating for war. I guess it didn't matter in the end.
We can continue this conversation later.
You know where I am. I'm listening.
Anything I should know?
I've nothing to report at the moment.
You seem to know a great many people.
I have made friends, and on occasion enemies. It's unavoidable.
We can continue this conversation later.
You know where I am.
Master Harris.
No, my lady, I don't know where the other nobles are. I suggest you ask Ambassador Montillier. Oh, you're her. Thryn, Inquisition Quartermaster. I'm doing what I can to supply this mess. If you find what I need to fill one of my requisitions, I'd appreciate you bringing it in.
What do you do here?
I make sure the Inquisition troops have food in their bellies and iron in their hands. Both are important. Lots of people expecting us to be heroes, marching all day to fight the demons. Turns out heroes need to dig latrines just like everyone else.
How does someone end up as quartermaster for the Inquisition?
I served for Eldon under Ten Logain MacTyr, best commanding officer this world has ever seen. After they all turned on him at Denerim, though, there wasn't much use for people who held that opinion. King Alistair offered my services to the Inquisition, probably to get rid of me.
With that attitude, I can't imagine how you made enemies in Denarim.
People just don't want to hear the truth. I was at Ostagar, and I know what really happened. King Kaelin overextended his position, and the Grey Wardens were too late lighting the signal. Following the original plan would have gotten everyone killed. Tern Loghain made the right decision. I apologize. Sister Liliana told me I shouldn't talk about this. Just forget it.
What did you mean when you mentioned requisitions?
I'm making this Inquisition run with what we have, but we're not a real army. We're stretched thin on materials, so I've put up a requisition list for anything that could help our people. Here, take a look. You find some iron and a good logging site. Maybe Harrit can get our troops better weapons.
If I have material for a special order, do I bring it to you?
Just take it over there. One of my boys will take the materials or jot down what you found.
Farewell.
Make a go with you. Thanks for checking anyway.
Let all repeat the chant of light.
I don't know if Apothecary Doss can get you that many healing drafts, revered mother.
How fares your quest to seal the breach?
I'm doing everything within my power.
A task such as closing the breach is a heavy burden. I hope you do not carry it alone. We remember Andraste, but Andraste did not carry the Chant of Light alone. She had generals, advisors, even her husband for a time. Do everything within your power, but remember those who would help you.
I appreciate your insight, Mother Giselle.
Take it for whatever it is worth. You walk a difficult path, and there is little enough I can do to aid you. In any case, I pray this Inquisition proves less brutal than its predecessor.
Do you know who the Grand Clerics will choose as the next Divine?
It is a difficult decision. All the obvious candidates perished with Divine Justinia at the Conclave. The Grand Clerics are terrified of the Inquisition. They will not decide soon, and I fear they will not decide wisely. Whoever is chosen needs the Inquisition's support. No one else seems likely to seal the breach.
How are the people doing after what happened at the Conclave?
They are scared, of course. Many have lost homes or loved ones. I doubt many will sleep well until you have sealed the breach. I have offered what help I can. The rest is for the Inquisition. What more do you wish to know?
How are the villagers in Haven doing?
They are terrified. Many of them came here because the war between the Mages and the Templars destroyed their homes. In their minds, the death of a Divine has destroyed any chance of peace. To that, add the breach. Farmers have fled their fields. If we do not restore order, half of Thedas may starve.
Do you have information on people elsewhere?
The refugees in the hinterlands are desperate. Without help, starvation or war will claim many lives. Villagers in Crestwood are besieged by their own dead. They have sent word begging for assistance. People are vanishing in the hills of Emprise de Lyon. It may be demons or something worse, but they are terrified. More than that, I cannot say. It is a chaotic time for all in Olay and Ferelden.
What are you doing to help these people?
My sisters and I have been tending to the injured as best we are able. Some refugees come with food, while others arrive empty-handed. I have helped ensure that all have enough to eat. Beyond that, many simply wish the familiar comfort of the Chant of Light. It is little enough work to offer some comfort to those in pain.
Farewell, revered mother.
Make her go with you.
The Inquisition cannot remain, Ambassador. You can't prove it was founded on Justinia's orders.
This is an inopportune time, Marquis. More of the faithful flock here each day. But allow me to introduce you to the brave soul who risked her life to slow the magic of the breach. Sir Trevelyan, may I present the Marquis Durellion, one of Divine Justinia's greatest supporters.
And the rightful owner of Haven. House Durellion lent Justinia these lands for pilgrimage. This Inquisition is not a beneficiary of this arrangement.
This is the first I've heard of Haven having an owner outside the Chantry.
My wife, Lady Machin of Denham, has claim to Haven by ancient treaty with the monarchs of Ferelden. We were honored to lend its use to Divine Justinia. She was a woman of supreme merit.
I will not let an upstart order remain on her holy grounds.
People have been injured. You can't just turn them out onto the snow.
And who benefits if they stay?
Divine Justinia, Marquis. The Inquisition, not the Chantry, is sheltering the pilgrims who mourn her.
Why is the Chantry ignoring the faithful?
Because it remains in shock.
We face a dark time, Your Grace. Divine Justinia would not want her passing to divide us. She would, in fact, trust us to forge new alliances to the benefit of all, no matter how strange they might seem.
I'll think on it, Lady Montpellier. The Inquisition might stay in the meanwhile.
Do the Durellions actually have a claim on this place?
His Grace's position is not so strong as he presents it. Despite our Ferelden relations, the Durellions are Orlesian. If the Marquis wishes to claim Haven, Empress Selene must negotiate with the Ferelden on his behalf. Her current concerns are a bit larger than minor property disputes.
I'm so pleased the Marquis isn't tossing us out into the cold.
His Grace is only the first of many dignitaries we must contend with.
You expect more people in Haven?
Undoubtedly. And each visitor will spread the story of the Inquisition after they depart. An ambassador should ensure the tale is as complimentary as possible.
May I ask, what brought you to work for the Inquisition?
Sister Leliana approached me. We've been acquainted for quite some time. For better or worse, being the Inquisition's diplomat has become as interesting as she promised.
What sort of dealings have you had with nobility?
For some years, I was the royally appointed court ambassador from Antiva to Orlais. The nobility of Thedas is a rather singular sphere. Those I'm not acquainted with, I know through reputation.
The Inquisition is lucky to have you as an advocate, Lady Montpellier.
Thank you. Let us hope so. Thedas' politics have become agitated as of late. I hope to guide us down smoother paths. But please excuse me. I've much work to do before the day is done.
If you find anything, please bring it in.
Greetings.
How do you and Leliana know each other?
We moved through similar circles in Norlay. I believe we actually met in Val Royale. Leliana was quite an accomplished player of the game by then.
What exactly do you mean when you say the game?
Forgive me. The game refers to the slow duels of influence among the noble and powerful of Orlais. It's a rather light-hearted name for the matter, but Orlesians are fond of playful touches.
What business are the Montpelliers in exactly?
We began as merchants. My ancestors founded the first trade routes to Rivain. We once sent entire fleets across the Waking Sea.
But not anymore?
No. These days, our vessels are a touch more modest.
I'd swear our families have met before.
Perhaps. Everyone of distinction in the Free Marches attends Lady Trevelyan's summer balls.
Great Aunt Lucille always did love a party.
I don't recall seeing you at any of them.
Attend one ball, and you'll fend off invites for a dozen more.
That reminds me. The Herald of Andraste has received several invitations from the curious.
To parties? How many am I getting?
Only 17 this month, I'm afraid.
What did you do before coming here?
I had the great honor of serving Antiva's crown as ambassador to Orlais. I'm also first in line to become the head of House Montpellier, though my siblings attend to our mercantile affairs.
How strong are your past loyalties?
I would never have given up my position if I did not intend to fully commit to the Inquisition. We cannot fall back on borders. We are as threatened as any country by the rebellions. If anything, the alliances I forged there may help our current cause.
Do you think the Inquisition will continue after we seal the breach?
If we prove ourselves by healing the breach, people may turn to us for other things. Protection, counsel, justice. The Inquisition offered these once to those in need.
Tell me, do you believe I was saved by Andraste at the Temple of Sacred Ashes?
I should much like to believe so, Your Worship. The miracles Andraste performed were so long ago, they're difficult to picture. If it were truly her and the Fate who saved you... Well, in any case, many already believe you walk in the Maker's Light.
Let's speak later.
Farewell. Good day to you.
Tell me how you came to work for the Inquisition again.
I'd been considering leaving my post in Antiva for a new challenge when Leliana recruited me. There's such unrest in Thedas, and the Inquisition seems a promising method to stop it. It's to everyone's benefit if we prevent the Mage-Templar conflict from spreading further.
So was it the prospect of stability that drew you here?
The full impact of the Mage Rebellion has yet to be felt, and that was before the death of the Divine. The violence must be curbed before we see it turn to full-scale war.
I can only imagine the bloodshed if it escalates further.
I'm afraid history holds many examples of what will happen if it does.
What exactly does your job entail?
I meet with ambassadors from various factions and countries, and cement alliances with them. We are a young cause. Diplomacy is essential to our credibility.
Then you speak for the Inquisition with these nobles?
I do. Someone must foster goodwill on our behalf, as well as prevent controversy as news of us spreads.
How heavily are our actions scrutinized?
Make no mistake. Every noble house, every throne, is waiting to see what the Inquisition does next. Many are willing to pledge support, if offers are made in just the right fashion. I intend to see that they are.
What do the people make of us?
Despite our fame, we're low on steadfast allies. We must aim for more.
Any visiting dignitaries I should watch out for?
Sir Griffith of Denerim, a most distinguished knight of the realm. He's defeated darkspawn, slain demons, chased down abominations. Just don't ask him about it over dinner. He spares no detail. Good day to you.
What do the people make of us?
Despite our fame, we're low on steadfast allies. We must aim for more.
Any thoughts on the people here?
Who did you mean?
What's your impression of Solas?
I suppose I should be wary of an apostate, but our elven mage has conducted himself with the utmost propriety. And he has the most fascinating stories.
Commander Cullen came to mind.
The commander is an intelligent, cautious man. I'm grateful he's in charge of our standing army. Still, he does sometimes resemble the man with a hammer to whom everything appears as a nail.
I was thinking of Cassandra.
Sigur Pentagast is a princess of the Kingdom of Nevarra, although that barely seems important to her. She was not interested when I asked if we might make use of her royal relations. Still, the Inquisition would not have formed without Cassandra. She's an extraordinarily driven woman.
I was thinking of Varric.
Oh, I could listen to his tales for hours. He actually let me read a chapter of his next book he's writing. My friends would be sick with envy if they knew. It's excellent, but a bit different from his past works. Only 3 beheadings so far.
Let's speak later.
Farewell. You're the Herald. Or, well, the one they're calling the Herald, anyway. I hope the Inquisition can restore order soon. I never really wanted to leave the Circle. My name is Mnave. I research demons and other creatures. Seeker Pentagast and I use what I find to help the soldiers fight them.
You said you were a mage?
No, just an apprentice. I was never very good at magic. I've got just enough talent to be a danger to other people. But when the mages rebelled, people like me had nowhere to go. The Templars would have killed us. Luckily, Seeker Pentagast took me in, along with the Tranquil I was protecting.
I'm surprised that even an apprentice mage wouldn't join the rebellion.
I don't like using magic to fight. I'm not good at it either. I liked studying. I liked performing rituals that helped us unlock the secrets of the Veil. I liked having the Templars around to keep us safe.
Most Circle mages I've met have a different opinion of the Templars.
They have not lived my life. I was born into a Dalish clan. I lived there until my magic manifested. The Dalish cannot risk having too many mages in one clan. And I was one more than they could bear. They gave me a pack and sent me into the woods to find my own life. I was 7 years old.
I'm so sorry.
I stumbled into a village, starving and cold a few weeks later. I started using magic to scare predators away. The villagers saw me make fire in my fist. They were terrified and wanted to kill me. Templars saved me from them. They gave me food and clothes and took me to the Circle. I've seen what life is like without the Templars, and I want no part of it. I just want to study.
You said that you were keeping some of the Tranquil safe.
Yes. The mages took some of them when my Circle rebelled, but the rest were forgotten. Most Circle mages look down on the Tranquil, or try to pretend they don't exist. They don't have any emotions. They can barely take care of themselves, can't defend themselves at all. It's a shame. I like them better than most people.
I'm glad they have someone who cares about them.
They deserve better. They're polite, they're rational, and they'll never get angry at you. When they study, they have a focus no normal person could ever match. But the Templars, even some of the mages, mistreated them just because they could. The Tranquil never fought back. If not for that, I don't know. Doesn't really matter now.
You said Cassandra has you researching creatures.
Yes. If you find anything interesting in your travels, I'd appreciate you bringing it to me. I may be able to find some weakness our soldiers can exploit when fighting various creatures. At the least, some materials are useful for making potions or gear for the Inquisition.
Why did you decide to research dangerous creatures?
I like the outdoors. The idea of the outdoors, anyway. When some monster is coming at you, glowing eyes and burning claws, it's terrifying. But once you know how it works, you can deal with it. It's just another part of the world. So much of this world is only frightening because we don't understand it.
I'll speak with you later.
Travel safely.
Fix the door just like you asked, Flitter. Master Harriet said I should go back right away. Yes, sir.
This area.
Adan is Haven's apothecary. He's been making potions and tending to the wounded as best he can. Harriet is the Inquisition's smith. Whatever he can make, you, Thren, the quartermaster, can probably find. And for anything fancier, you can try buying from Segrit. His prices aren't too high. Yet. Oh, there's also Minae. She studies beasts and things, as I understand.
Farewell.
Goodbye.
Position troops out at Redcliffe now, giving those people some real help.
Sigrid asked, told me that he can't let the herbs go for anything less than 8.
Fine. We'll gather our own. Tell Sigrid he better hope he doesn't need a salve anytime soon. Look who's back from the dead. Again.
I don't recall meeting you before.
I'd be surprised if you did. You weren't particularly coherent. Someone had to patch you up after you staggered out of making those where, though. So, you're welcome.
I didn't realize. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, you can pay me back by fixing the world. Name's Adan. I'm in charge of keeping our little band here stocked with potions and elixirs. Not that Seeker Pentagast seems to care whether we've got the supplies to actually do that.
For a healer, you don't seem particularly nurturing.
I'm not a healer. I'm an alchemist who's forced to play Mother Hen. You want something to burst into flame on contact with the air? Done. Gladly. Patching up wounded soldiers is a waste of my time and talents. But there are a few around who can help.
How are your people holding up?
We've got Mother Giselle lending a hand now, which helps. For the ones that need comforting more than actual healing, she's a rock in fast water. Something to cling to.
How do I go about having potions made?
Just take a look there and tell me what you'd like. Find a recipe for something better, I can make that too. You're back. And in one piece.
Is there anything I can do to help out?
We're fine as far as raw labor goes. You've more important things to do than tend to me. I only wish I'd been able to find Master Tajin's notes. Old bastard was working on something special. He died at the conclave, and his notes weren't here. Been too busy dealing with the wounded to look for them.
Farewell.
Perhaps another time.
Chosen of Andraste, a blessed hero sent to save us all.
I didn't ask for this, but someone has to find a way to seal the breach.
Spoken nobly indeed. You think I'm mocking you? This age has made people cynical. I've journeyed deep into the fade in ancient ruins and battlefields to see the dreams of lost civilizations. I've watched as hosts of spirits clash to reenact the bloody past in ancient wars, both famous and forgotten. Every great war has its heroes. I'm just curious what kind you'll be.
What do you mean, ruins and battlefields?
Any building strong enough to withstand the rigors of time as a history. Every battlefield is steeped in death. Both attract spirits. They press against the veil, weakening the barrier between our worlds. When I dream in such places, I go deep into the fade. I can find memories no other living being has ever seen.
You fall asleep in the middle of ancient ruins. Isn't that dangerous?
I do set wards. And if you leave food out for the giant spiders, they are usually content to live and let live.
I've never heard of anyone going so far into the Fade. That's extraordinary.
Thank you. It's not a common field of study, for obvious reasons. Not so flashy as throwing fire or lightning. The thrill of finding remnants of a 1,000-year-old dream? I would not trade it for anything. I will stay there. At least until the breach has been closed.
Was that in doubt?
I am an apostate surrounded by Chantry forces in the middle of a mage rebellion. Cassandra has been accommodating. But you understand my caution.
Cassandra trusts you. She won't let anyone put you into a circle against your will.
Thank you. I appreciate the thought. But now let us hope either the mages or the Templars have the power to seal the breach.
closing the breach is our primary goal. But I hope we might also discover what was used to create it. Any artifact of such power is dangerous. The destruction of the Conclave proves that much.
You don't think whatever created the explosion was destroyed in the blast?
You survived, did you not? The artifact that created the breach is unlike anything seen in this age. I will not believe it destroyed until I see the shattered fragments with my own eyes.
Anything with that kind of power is bound to show up sooner or later.
Liliana's people have scoured the area near the blast and found nothing. Whatever the artifact was, it is no longer there. In any case, did you need me for anything?
What do you know about the Fade?
A great deal, from my wanderings. There are a few hard facts, but I can share what I have learned.
I'd like to know more about the breach.
Simply put, it is a tear in the veil between this world and the Fae, allowing spirits to enter the world physically. Small tears occur naturally when magic weakens the veil, or when spirits cluster in an area that has seen many deaths. But your mark allows you to exert some control over the breach. That means it was created deliberately.
I'd like to know more about the veil.
Circle mages call it a barrier between this world and the Fae. But according to my studies in ancient Elven lore, that is a vast oversimplification. Without it, imagine if spirits entered freely. The Fade was not a place one went, but a state of nature like the wind.
It sounds like it would be wonderful.
And dangerous. But yes, a world where imagination defines reality. Where spirits are as common as trees or grass. Instead, spirits are strange and fearful, and the Fade is a terrifying world touched only by mages and dreamers. I am glad that I'm not alone in seeing the beauty of such a world, along with the obvious peril.
I'd like to know more about demons.
The Chantry says that demons hate the natural world and seek to bring their chaos and destruction to the living. But such simplistic labels misconstrue their motivations, and in so doing, do all a great disservice. Spirits wish to join the living, and a demon? That wish gone wrong.
Is there a way to coexist? To live with them? If not in peace, at least without such active confrontation?
Not in the world we know today. The veil creates a barrier that makes true understanding most unlikely. But the question is a good one, and it matters that you thought to ask.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye. As I explored the Fade, I felt the presence of an intriguing artifact in the hinterlands. If you are willing, I would like to locate it. I have marked its location as best I could determine.
I'd like to know more about you, Solas.
Why?
You're an apostate, yet you risked your freedom to help the Inquisition.
Not the wisest course of action when framed that way.
I appreciate the work you're doing, Solas. I just wanted to know more about you.
I'm sorry. So much fear in the air. What would you know of me?
What made you start studying the Fade?
I grew up in a village to the north. There was little to interest a young man, especially one gifted with magic. But as I slept, spirits of the Fade showed me glimpses of wonders I had never imagined. I treasured my dreams. Being awake, out of the Fade, became troublesome.
Did spirits try to tempt you?
No more than a brightly colored fruit is deliberately tempting you to eat it. I learned how to defend myself from more aggressive spirits and how to interact safely with the rest. I learned how to control my dreams with full consciousness. There was so much I wanted to explore.
I gather you didn't spend your entire life dreaming.
No. Eventually, I was unable to find new areas in the Fade.
Why?
Two reasons. First, the Fade reflects the world around it. Unless I traveled, I would never find anything new. Second, the Fade reflects and is limited by our imaginations. If you find interesting areas, one must be interesting.
Is this why you joined the Inquisition?
I joined the Inquisition because we were all in terrible danger.
If our enemies destroy the world, I would have nowhere to lay my head while dreaming of the Fade.
I wish you luck.
Thank you. In truth, I've enjoyed experiencing more of life to find more of the Fade.
How so?
You train to flick a dagger or an arrow to its target. The grace with which you move is a pleasing sight, then. You have chosen a path whose steps you do not dislike because it leads to a destination you enjoy. As have I.
You said you'd traveled to many different places.
This world, or its memory, is reflected in the Fade. Dream in ancient ruins, and you may see a city lost to history. Some of my fondest memories were found in crumbling cities, long picked dry by treasure seekers, the best of the battlefields. Spirits pressed so tightly on the veil that you can slip across with but a thought.
Any place in particular?
I dreamt of Ostagar. I witnessed the brutality of the Darkspawn and the valor of the Ferelden warriors. I saw Alistair and the hero Ferelden light the signal fire, and Loghain's infamous betrayal of Caelan's forces.
I've heard the stories. It would be interesting to hear what it was really like.
That's just it. In the Fade, I see reflections created by spirits who react to the emotions of the warriors. One moment, I see heroic wardens lighting the fire and a power-mad villain sneering as he lets King Caelan fall. The next, I see an army overwhelmed and a veteran commander refusing to let more soldiers die in a lost cause.
And you can't tell which is real.
It is the Fade. They are all real.
Have you always traveled and studied alone?
Not at all. I have built many lasting friendships. Spirits of wisdom, possessed of ancient knowledge, happy to share what they had seen. Spirits of purpose helped me search. Even wisps, curious and playful, would point out treasures I might have missed.
I don't know of any spirits by those names.
They rarely seek this world. When they do, their natures do not often survive exposure to the people they encounter. Wisdom and purpose are too easily twisted to pride and desire.
You're saying that you became friends with Pride and Desire demons?
They were not demons for me.
Meaning?
The Fade reflects the minds of the living. If you expect a spirit of wisdom to be a pride demon, it will adapt. And if your mind is free of corrupting influences, if you understand the nature of the spirit, they can be fast friends.
I'm impressed that you could become friends with spirits.
Anyone who can dream has the potential. Few ever try. My friends comforted me in grief and shared my joy. Yet, because they exist without form, as we understand it, the Chantry declares that spirits are not truly people. Is Cassandra defined by her cheekbones and not her faith? Varric by his chest hair and not his wit?
I hadn't thought about it that way, but I see your point.
Thank you. Few are willing to entertain such a notion.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye. Hello.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
Listen, I'm not saying that the Chantry doesn't do
good.
I
suppose you're right. Can I get you anything?
Farewell.
Goodbye.
Have you left me?
So,
Now that Cassandra's out of earshot, are you holding up all right? I mean, you go from being the most wanted criminal in Thedas to joining the armies of the faithful. Most people would have spread that out over more than one day.
I have no idea what's happening anymore.
That makes two of us. For days now, we've been staring at the breach, watching demons and Maker knows what fall out of it. Bad for morale would be an understatement. I still can't believe anyone was in there and lived.
If it was that bad, why did you stay? Cassandra said you were free to go.
I like to think I'm as selfish and irresponsible as the next guy, but this... thousands of people died on that mountain. I was almost one of them. And now there's a hole in the sky. Even I can't walk away and just leave that to sort itself out.
I'm still not sure I believe any of this is really happening.
If this is all just the Maker winding us up, I hope there's a damn good punchline coming. You might want to consider running at the first opportunity. I've written enough tragedies to recognize where this is going. Heroes are everywhere. I've seen that. But the hole in the sky... heroes. We're going to need a miracle.
Need something?
I read your Tale of the Champion, and I have a few questions.
That's a pretty common reaction. Go ahead.
What happened to the mage who destroyed the Kirkwall Chantry? The book never said.
He fled Kirkwall with the mages from the Circle. Stayed with them a while, but he had to move on. Somehow a lot of mages blamed him for making them live as fugitives. I don't know where he is now, and I don't want to know.
In the book, you say that first Enchanter Orsino turned himself into a giant monster made of corpses. How? Why?
Do I look like an expert on magical weirdness to you? Well, I can't tell you how. But the why, all I can say is he was desperate.
There's no way Hawk really could have killed the Arashok. It would have started a war with the Kunari.
I was told later that the Kunari disavowed his actions. Apparently the Arashok didn't get permission before he attacked Kirkwall, and the Kuhn didn't want another exalted march. When they finally sent a ship to haul the Red Dreadnought away, they just said, "We will never speak of this again." As far as I can tell, that's the Kuhn's version of an apology.
Where are the rest of Hawk's associates now?
Meryl decided to look after the elves left homeless by the fighting. She's done a pretty good job of keeping them away from the mages and Templars, so far. I guess she has plenty of practice avoiding stupid human battles with her old Dalish clan. Fenris has kept himself busy, hunting down the Tevinter slavers who came south to prey on the refugees. I'm not sure exactly where he is at the moment. You can usually follow the trail of corpses, though. Isabella went back to the Raiders. She's calling herself an admiral now. I don't know if she's actually in charge or just has a really big hat. Might be the same thing, honestly. Sebastian went back to Starkhaven. I'm sure he's boring all sorts of people there. Last I knew, Hawk's sister Bethany was doing something wardeny near the Anderfels border. Aveline is still guard captain. I'm pretty sure Kirkwall would fall into the sea if she quit her job. Need something?
The red lyrium we found at the temple seemed to upset you.
My brother Bartrand and I sort of discovered red lyrium during an expedition in the Deep Roads. We located an ancient tig, so old it barely looked dwarven. There was this idol there made of it. Bartrand brought it back to the surface, and, well, everything's gone downhill from there.
So what is it? Just another kind of lyrium?
The red stuff is lyrium like a dragon is a lizard. It's not just a different color. It has a whole host of weirdness all its own. I've written to every mining cast house in Orzammar. No one's seen this stuff before or knows where it came from.
What makes it special?
Regular lyrium can mess you up pretty badly, but you have to ingest it for that to happen. red lyrium messes with your mind when you're just near the stuff. You hear singing, get violent, paranoid, and then it does creepy shit. Makes things float, brings statues to life. It also turned Kirkwall's Night Commander to lyrium. Everyone's been kept at least 100 paces from it since.
How did the red lyrium get in the Temple of Sacred Ashes?
I don't know. So as far as I knew, the only piece to make it to the surface was destroyed. And the location of the tag it came from is a secret. Did someone find more of it in the Deep Roads? That's not a cheery thought.
I think that's enough on red lyrium.
Yeah, not really my favorite subject. Need something?
Can I ask you something, Varric?
You want to talk about me? I'm flattered. Also inclined toward extravagant lies.
Are you from Ferelden, Olay?
Free Marches, born and raised in Kirkwall. And despite whatever you've heard, no, Kirkwall's not that bad.
I'm not clear on your line of work. You're a merchant?
I'm a businessman. My family has a seat in the Dwarven Merchants Guild. Merchants buy and sell goods. Businessmen buy and sell stores. In my spare time, I manage a spy network, and occasionally, I write books.
What sort of shops do you own?
Actually, we don't own shops. That was just an example. Mostly we invest in moneylenders. Auction houses, a few mercenary companies, a couple of smithies. I think we own half a beet plantation in Ravain somewhere. Most of that's my brother's doing. Bartrand had business sense. Not much tact, but loads of business sense.
If you've run a spy network, why is Leliana our spy master?
To be honest with you, she's just a better spy master. The truly great ones can keep their distance. They don't get attached to their people. Me, I always wind up babysitting my informants and worrying about their families. We're in better hands with her.
You're an author. What kind of books have you written?
I've tried my hands at a few genres. My crime serials are my most popular. Hard in Hightown, guards breaking the rules to get things done. The Tale of the Champion is the most famous thing I've written, or infamous, maybe. I started a romance serial once, Swords and Shields, but to be honest, I don't have a knack for romances. Most of my stories end in tragedy. Probably that says something unfortunate about me personally.
How do you and Cassandra know each other?
You heard about the Kirkwall Chantry being destroyed? The guy responsible used to be a friend of mine. The Seeker had questions about that, and I had answers.
Where did you get that crossbow? I've never seen one like it.
Bianca? She's one of a kind. I got her off a guy in Darktown. Took me a week to pry his dead fingers off the stock.
Who is she named for?
I can't tell you.
And the reason for that is?
Complicated. It's the one story I'll never tell. We just have to leave it at that.
Thanks, Varric.
No problem.
Thank you.
while since I built one of these. Pray to the Maker that I'd never have to build another.
I guess the Maker paid you as much attention as he pays everyone else.
Don't talk like that, boy. I lived through the siege of Denerim by the Maker's grace. We're doing the Maker's work in the Inquisition. If we get out of a hard fight alive, we'll thank you kindly for it. To thing up so it can pivot. No telling which direction it'd be coming from.
Stand only in places you have blessed.
Ah, you're awake and out of Lady Cassandra's clutches. And here I paid that little knife-ear to inform me the moment you were free. No matter, no matter. Segret, honored to meet you. Thank you for all you've done. Hopefully, we'll still do.
What do you think I'll be doing, exactly?
Word's already spreading that if anyone could close that blighted thing in the sky, it's you. Anything you need is yours. For a reasonable price, of course. Supplies are a little tight, given the circumstances.
What kind of person stays to run a shop at a time like this?
The kind with nowhere else to go. Those blasted demons destroy most of my goods. If I stay here, work some contacts, I can start rebuilding. Maybe, just maybe, help you folks out in the process.
You must speak with most everyone here. How are people doing?
Hope and fear in equal measure. No one really knows what it means when an Inquisition is called. Yet, I imagine it's no better for you. You've got my sympathies, for what it's worth.
Can I see what you have for sale?
Of course. My wares are at the table.
Thank you.
If the Inquisition wants to field a decent cavalry, it needs better forces. I heard Seeker Pentagast might try to acquire suitable mounts from Master Dennett in the Hinterlands.
Oh, and who are you to be fishing around for what the higher-ups are doing?
Back in Angsburg, my uncle was...
Expected you'd be by. I'm Harrit, and everyone knows who you are. How's the new gear fit?
Sturdy and warm. It's perfect.
Good. World's gone mad. Stock armor and blades are good against bandits, but we're not fighting bandits. My gear will see you through demons, apostates, whatever this world throws at you. So, you need custom work. You bring the materials to us, we'll make it happen.
How did you come to be here?
Come from a little town called Lothring. Long gone now. I was in Redcliffe when the Darkspawn hit it during the Blight. Helped rebuild. Left when Royalty decided it was time to hand the place over to the bloody mages. Ended up here. Just missed the boot. Can't decide if I'm the luckiest son of a bitch walking or the exact opposite.
You're still walking. That's always good.
True enough.
How did you come to be here?
Long story. Not worth telling twice.
Who outfits the Inquisition's soldiers?
Not me. I've got work to do. Can't be passing a sword to every blighter who signs up. If you want to help the troops, talk to Thren, the quartermaster. She'll set up requisitions.
Does the Inquisition not have supplies to make armor or weapons?
Tough convincing traders to haul up here. Impossible to get them to risk the rare stuff, so that's on you.
What can you and your team make here?
Arms and armor. We work iron to blighted dragonbone, if you've got it. Our designs are simple, but they get the job done. You want something fancy, bring your own design. We'll see what we can do.
If I want something, what can you make?
Start simple. Something to keep you safe. Take a look at it on the table there and we can talk. You'll need materials. We should have what you want just outside.
Can you help improve my arms and armor?
Yes. You find a new piece, a pauldron or greaves, we'll take care of you. You can't just slap a new hilt on your sword in the field. Bring it here, we'll make sure it's done right and proper.
Goodbye.
Right.
Lisa thought you and your men might be working on the third. Please send me over to see if you need it.
Maker, though the darkness comes upon me, I shall embrace the light. I shall weather the storm. I shall endure.
Can I help you with something?
Farewell.
Maker, go with you. Excellent. I did not see good Templars and evil beings.
We're going to have new verses in the Chant of Light, but the Herald of Andraste.
You're back. And in one piece.
You said you thought Master Tajan was working on something special. If it helps, I found his notes.
The old codger was on the edge of a breakthrough here, but he couldn't see it. You want some of these mixed up? You just give the word.
Farewell.
See no signs of the Grey Wardens anywhere. You're certain?
Firestone. Grey Wardens, you said?
We're not paying you to be sarcastic.
Would that I could.
Right. That's why.
Yes, sir.
You're certain?
Keep an eye out.
something like that.
Can they find the key, the kennel of the past? We're hiding from the fighting, longing to see. We're waiting for someone to speak and set us all free.
Ask around again tomorrow.
Thank you.
See? What did I tell you?
Thank you.
Welcome back.
What do you mean? Have you seen otherwise?
It's just what I heard.
Well, let me know if you find one.